Welcome back from that break. You're still watching the news with me, Margarine Namugenyi. Moving on, the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, on Thursday signed off regulations detailing procedures for applying the National Social Security Fund, known as NSSF. Midterm access and the process starts tomorrow, Monday, 7th of March. Members can now apply for up to 20% of their savings. On January 4th, President Yoweri Museveni assented to the NSSF Amendment Act 2021, paving the way for workers who are 45 years and above and have served for at least 10 years to have the midterm access of up to 20% of their savings. Persons with disabilities who are 40 years and above and have also served with the NSSF for at least 10 years will access up to 50% of their accrued savings. As of the end of 2021, NSSF, a national savings scheme mandated by the government of Uganda, is to provide social security services to employees in Uganda, had 2 million contributors and over 15 trillion in assets. However, 5 trillion was held in equities and real estate. Richard Biarugaba said that at the end of the 2021 that NSSF would have to liquidate some of its fixed income assets like bonds to cater for midterm access payments. Now, to throw some insights into this development, we have a business journalist, Paul Wusherizi, with us in the studios. Welcome to the news, Paul Wusherizi.
Thank you.
Now, please help us understand, eligibility for the midterm access includes members who have been remitting for 120 months. How realistic has NSSF been with qualification for beneficiaries, you think?
I think the challenge was, first of all, midterm access was always in the plan. NSSF has had a strategic plan to have midterm access. The nature of the midterm access we're talking about was that I think after saving for a certain period of time, you'd be able to get funds to take you back to school. Maybe you got a master's or a PhD, whatever the case may be. Some health access, a mortgage to buy or build a house. Those are the three things I remember. So this came almost as a reaction to the COVID situation. People were struggling. This was in 2020. People were struggling. They needed money, and they thought, you know, maybe why doesn't NSSF release some of the money? So in trying to determine who we give them, they have decided on 120 months. So that means that
anyone below that,
for example, if I'm 45 and I've saved for 10 years, it's not the same as having saved for 100. I could have saved for 3 years and stopped 10 years ago.
Okay.
But now they want you to have saved for 10
years.
Yeah, you want to. Most. I think the whole thing is really to manage the liquidity situation. Otherwise, you know, it would be a huge cost, huge charge on the NSSF funds. And as has already been said elsewhere, you know, the interest rate this year might not be as good as it's been because of all this huge outflow of money.
Okay. So now, Minister for Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, said NSSF will pay 50 billion shillings a week to midterm access beneficiaries. Question is, 50 billion shillings per week is quite a lot of money, especially for the body that has experienced scandalous losses. Some people are skeptical about the management of the process, and are their worries legitimate?
Well, 50 billion is a lot of money by any standards, but if I'm not wrong, I think the last I had, NSSF was collecting about 70 billion shillings. That was last year, 70 billion shillings a month. It has 15 trillion assets, some of which it can liquidate. It's very prudent for them to stagger the payment over a period of time. They couldn't just pay. The last estimate I saw was 1 trillion shillings is going to go to this midterm access. So to pay it at one time would be too much of a thing. So it's a good idea for them to stagger it. NSSF's scandalous losses, it's been a while since we've had scandalous losses at NSSF. So I don't think that's playing in our minds. I think what's playing in our minds is you know, can they do the process smoothly in terms of Because I've been preparing for it here.
Yes.
How do you apply? Can we have it the most with the least inconvenience? And I think they're ready for that. Yeah.
Okay. Finally, NSSF has been developing capabilities to efficiently process and pay midterm benefits to qualifying members for 5 months. Was that sufficient, and is it good timing?
Well, we're going to know tomorrow. We're going to know tomorrow, but what I knew was that they were ready by the end of last year, end of 2021. So they've been stress testing the system ever since. So for now 2 months. The thing with these things is that you never know until the thing starts whether you're ready
exactly.
or not. But I'm made to understand they've put the necessary processes in place. They're going to have a physical process. I had the minister, I think, talking last week about having physical places for registration in Kololo and around the country.
Yeah.
But they have an app. You can do it off your phone, your smartphone, or you can do it on their website.
App?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can do it off the website. And you can do it with the USSD codes. So, as I said, you know, we're going to know when it starts, whether they were ready or not.
Okay.
But their systems have been kind of robust for the last few years. So I am confident enough they'll get through it.
Okay, that was the business journalist Paul Wisharizi. Thank you so much for joining us on the news. Hope
You're
to
welcome.
Have you next time. Let's see what's going to take place tomorrow. We shall be bringing you the details and updates from the NSSF if the money and the midterm access will be worked on tomorrow. The news now takes a short break. Stay tuned.